Instead of having to draw all your lines at a 30 degree angle, or to use an isometric grid to draw isometric objects, Adobe Illustrator has a feature that will do this for you and make life easier. In this guide, I will show you how to do that by drawing a simple isometric house. So open up a new document, then select onto the rectangle tool, select a simple grey colour for the main part of the house, and then change the stroke colour to none. Click onto the centre of the canvas and keep the width and height to 100 pixels. Now you have this selected, go on to Effect, 3D, Extrude and Bevel, and then you'll get this window pop up and a list of options. If you click onto Preview, you can see how the shape will turn out. At the moment you can see it's not exactly in a isometric angle. So to do that, go to Position at this drop down menu and select onto Isometric Top. And now you can see this has been drawn out onto an isometric angle. To make this into a cube, we need to set the extrude depth to 100 points. Then, once you click off to there and you click on anywhere, you can see with preview, you can see the cube come up. Now I clicked OK. Now we have the cube here. Now to build the roof of the house, select the polygon tool, then select a colour for the roof, probably a dark orange would be good, and click onto canvas, and here, set the sides to 3, go OK, I need to stretch this out a bit. Do the same as you did with the cube, and go 3D, extrude and bevel. I'll preview to see what's happening here. Let's put it to isometric right. We'll do, as you see, we've got a mixture of different isometric options. For us, right would be good. And I'd like there to be more light on the front face of the triangle. So one way to do this is to go more options, and here you can just adjust the lighting here. You can see the side of that. It could change the lighting a bit so it's lighter on the front, a bit darker on the side. It looks good. And then we want this to be just a little bit longer than the top, a little bit longer than the length of the house. Let's set this to 110 points. Okay, that looks good. So we go OK. And I'm positioning this on top. Oops. Now I'm positioning this on top of the house like this. You just have to judge it by eye. Place it onto there. So just so it looks right. There you have the roof for now. And the windows. This rectangle tool again. Select a light blue. We just need to make this. Maybe you just do this by hand. So make this quite small. Put one out there for one window. Then you can just copy and paste another one here. These are our two windows. Now, if we want to do a door, go to rectangle tool again. Select a brown. Just draw out a nice little rectangle here. Now we've got, make sure we have both of these selected. And once again, go to 3D, extrude and bevel. And then we'll set this to isometric right. And you see here, we've still got an extrude depth here. Now for these objects, we don't want any extrude depth. We just want them flat, just to go into the front of the house. So we delete that and set that to 0. And now we've got them there like that. It's still quite dark, so we'll go into the light shading again. Adjust it here just so they're a bit lighter and they go with the front. Good and got okay. Now these will have to position these in front of the house like that. Should you buy I for now. Zoom in a bit just to see, make sure it all lines up. But one tip would be to use the line tool here just to make sure these are all lined up. Let's set them at this angle here. Make sure it's even. Make sure it lines up with the first one. So we've got that there. And you can see this one here, it's out of line, so we can just move that up, nudge it up. And then both of these are in line. Maybe move this down a little bit here. Just to even out the spacing, I think. And there you go. Here is our house. Just in a basic isometric shape. As you can see from just doing this here, this is just a simple shape. But once you play around with it more and get used to playing around with the extrude and bevel too, you can build much more complicated and interesting shapes. Thank you for watching.